as well as comic acting sequences, tender dramatic moments, huge stage fights, and big dance numbers, there are also plenty of songs in the show.
There's a gospel song, there's a tango, there's pop songs, love duets.
The theatre school boasts some brilliant vocal talent, and the creative team are keen to showcase this. But with musical numbers in all manner of styles, only time will tell if the cast can master the songs and hit the notes in time for the first night. Upstairs in the costume department, Vic and the rest of the costume team have got their work cut out, making over 20 costumes for the show.
Okay, this is the costume department. I'm Vic and I'm costume supervisor for Dick Whittington. I'll just show you what we're doing. This is a hired costume for the day in which we're just putting a few different things. He's going to have a teddy bear and stuff. This is when he's just woken up.
Well, I remember all this when I wake up.
What do you think?
This is Antonia, and she's just fitting the seaweed skirt for the beach scene for the dame. This is the fat suit. Basically, we've just built a lycra bodysuit for him and then pad it out with layers of wadding to give Nicholas the figure of a busty lady, basically. It's unfinished because it'll then be covered with flesh-coloured lycra, so it looks like his skin. This is the dame's final costume in progress. It's the walk-down costume. Currently, the components parts are all being made, and here's the pig's heads. And then you've also got the cabbage leaves, which will all be coming up around the neck here. And so they're just being made, and then they'll all be stitched on. And it will be finished, and then there's also a hat that goes with it that's a pie with the birds in.
Today we started by working on my entrance on page 15, where Dame Sarah the Cook's first entrance, saying hello to the boys and girls, introducing herself. And then I've got a little bit of a song there as well, which is mainly spoken, which suits me fine.
I'm Sarah the Cook of the household. My kitchen is buff to a sheen. I look at my face in a work top, and looking right back is a queen. Famed for me raw awful souffle. I can serve it on toast or with gin. Do try, but I wouldn't advise it. You might die with a hideous grin.
I must say there's one thing I cannot eat for breakfast. What's that?
Supper.
You don't have to kind of do it.
Oh, right, okay.
I don't mean that to be insulting. It's just it's not helping you. So you can literally keep it very clean. The one thing I cannot eat for breakfast, what's that?
Supper!
Oh, well, please yourself.
Okay.
So you don't have to... If you take out those little extra laughs,
yeah,
what it actually buys you is the ability to springboard straight into the next.
I don't think I've quite got there with the character yet. We've just put our scripts down, and it's quite difficult and needs lots of energy, but hopefully I'll get there soon.
We've come down here to show the cast kind of what happens down Machine Road, the construction side of it and the scenic art side of it. And it's just kind of nice to get out for a bit, to be honest with you. It's just nice to come down and have a bit of a change of scenery, literally. Yeah.
So that essentially is the frame she's made, which supports everything around it. So yeah, I do this all on the computer and then give it to these guys, who will then start building it with the different tools, the different ways of joining flats together. We usually use mortise and...
Kathy from Scenic Art suggested that we all, you know, bring everyone to see the work. And I think it's a really good idea, because A, it's great fun. It gets everyone very excited about what they're about to do. It makes sense when they then go back into a bare rehearsal room. But also they realise quite how hard everyone is working around them. You know, not just them. They're sweating blood on the rehearsal room floor, but everyone around involved in the production is working really hard as well.
You don't think about all this going on, do you?
No. It's
so funny.
It just appears on the day.
While the actors head back to rehearsals, the scenic artists get back to work. Pantomimes are famous for having huge backdrops and lavish sets, and it's the scenic artists who are responsible for providing that all-important panto look. It can take weeks to paint the huge show cloths, with layer upon layer of paint required to give it the perfect final finish. Back at the theatre school, the technical departments are working flat out. The sound department are busy mixing the music for the show, while next door the lighting department has over 100 lights to clean and service, ready to be rigged in the theatre at the weekend.
But I mean, the company feel is terrific. I mean, the story and the characters are really being very clearly told. But we will now have 2 days of, you know, endless unpicking and unpicking. But it will all sort of come back together on Thursday. So marvellous. So top of the show, end of the overture.
We've done a couple of runs now. We've got a week to go. And so we just want to get in the theatre and start rehearsing. And once we've done all that and props and all that sort of thing, once we've run through that a couple of times, I think I'll feel a lot more comfortable.
3 days later, and the enormous task of the set fit-up is well underway. The schedule leading up to opening night is very tight, with each department having just a few hours to transform the theatre. It's all hands to the stage in preparation for the arrival of the actors and the start of the technical rehearsals.
Today we're going to have a health and safety talk.
No bare feet backstage or for warm-ups, you must wear shoes. Valuables to Stevie, if you trust Stevie. Beware of moving scenery. Scenery will be moving around you and you will know where it is moving on stage because of the tech, so you will know where it's happening.
I've seen scary guard dogs in Hannah Montana's poodle parlour.
Please, Nick, back to stage, please.
Yeah.
Stand by on stage from the same place, please.
When that tech run's done, we start to dress the show. At the moment, there are scheduled 3 dresses. That might not happen. We'll have to wait and see. But if we do get 3 dresses, it would be brilliant, because that's 3 attempts before opening night to get it right. And if we don't get it right, then opening night will be the night.
We found out that our first night is sold out and that we have press in as well, quite a few press, so the pressure is building up for the first night.
But I think I will be really nervous on opening night when it comes to it, because of, as I say, that kind of surprise element of it. You just don't know what's going to happen, you don't know how the kids are going to react.
No need for applause, dear. I ask only for a little sympathy.
Romance is blossoming in front of the show cloth, while behind, a well-orchestrated scene change gets underway. The team race against the clock. They have the length of just one musical number to get the set changed. It's just minutes before the curtains are opened and all is revealed.
I really think the show works, and I would absolutely stake my reputation on saying that it's probably, certainly in terms of repertory theatre pantos, it would absolutely hold its own with any rep theatre panto in the country.
I get a buzz at the end when it's all gone well. The actors get the applause, but we've worked with them enough for them to know what we've put into it and for us to know what they've put into it. And so we do all kind of share it. And I love that feeling.
We've done, you know, 4 weeks rehearsal, we've had 6 run-throughs, we've done 3 dress rehearsals, so the show is very tight. These guys know exactly what they're doing. So to go out and do that show with that kind of noise in the crowd and to handle it and control it is a really skillful job. I was just thrilled. I mean, just thrilled. I think the songs have come up really well. The company was fantastic. That was a really good night.